Hey all, welcome to ShareTrek. This is Raj here. Friends, I am very excited today to share some information about a comment I got recently in our HIV channel. It seems that we are attracting people from bioengineering as well. So not all of our videos are watched by HIV patients, but also being watched by people who are studying medicine and other areas. And a very interesting question has come to me from a person called Ujwal. And what he asked me was, as a student of biomedical engineering, I believe EBT101 is the most potential therapy for HIV cure. I also think that it will be too costly, costing around $2 million. What do you think about this? And he's saying, in March 2025, is EBT completing its phase one or phase two? So I've already answered him, but I think Ujwal brings out a very good question. And it can be shared with the broader audience. So I'd like to talk about EBT101 very briefly, but I want to talk more about the delivery mechanisms in this video. So EBT101, for those who have not seen my earlier videos, is a gene therapy which aims to go to cells which are infected with HIV, go to the nucleus, and then make three cuts on the HIV provirus, which is embedded on the human genome. And the cuts are going to make sure that a substantial portion of the HIV virus is removed. And the cuts aim to well-preserved areas which do not mutate as much, so that it is easier to find and reliably found and dissected. So as a result of which, the potential of eliminating all HIV virus which is embedded in the active cells is theoretically possible. Now that leaves us with hidden and dormant cells. And for hidden and dormant cells, one could also look at using an agent that can stimulate the dormant HIV to start being active so that it can be seen by EBT, and EBT can go and excise the HIV genome from there. So it takes care of that aspect as well. And there are some studies going on, I believe, separate from EBT101, which are looking at the shock and kill kind of approach. And EBT can be the kill, and shock has to come from some other agency or medicine that can be used in combination with EBT101. So that can take us so far. But in order for EBT to succeed, it has got two problems that it needs to address. And because we do not know as much about EBT101 as probably people within Excision Bio does, I think they're already on top of all these problems and they must be working towards it. But as outside observers, I would say that there are two areas that they might want to look at. One is reaching every part of the body, because HIV virus goes and sits at every possible part of the body. That's one. And when you talk about every part of the body, there's a specialized part of the body which is very difficult to access. That is the blood-brain barrier, which has to be crossed in order to get into the brain. And we know that there are HIV reservoirs in the brain as well. So this is where the complication begins, right? How do you reach different extremes of the body and cover all cell types where HIV would reside? So what kind of a delivery vector you would use? We know that EBT101 uses adeno-associated virus. So AAV can go several places. There are companies which have been modifying the AAV. I believe a strain called AAV9 can be modified further to get through the blood-brain barrier. And if the AAV can get through, it can also carry the gene functions, gene editing payload, and do whatever is needed in the brain cells as well. But the question is, are such AAVs already available? So I think the answer from my side is that, to the best of my knowledge, work is ongoing and the BBB is not fully understood with respect to AAV crossing over it. So is it a good thing? How do we control it? How do we monitor the side effects? All those things have to be worked out. But if EBT101 was able to remove all the active copies and all the as much of the hidden passive dark pools, or whatever you may call it, dormant HIV, then that only goes so far. And so they will have to work with some specialty AAV companies, I suppose, and get a cocktail of AAVs in which they can put the genetic payload, gene editing payload, and then they will have to calibrate the cocktail so that it can go to all parts of the body, because AAV can be designed to go to various organs, and a cocktail of all the different AAVs that can go to different part of the bodies, including the one that goes to the brain, will have to be created, I suppose, in order to address all possible cells in which HIV can reside actively or dormantly. And if that is done, then we come to the next aspect, which is the clinical trials and the results. So as we start crossing the blood-brain barrier, things become very interesting, and the risk factor increases, and FDA will be looking at it very, very closely to certify. So in my mind, I'm thinking the trajectory of EBT101 could possibly be that it could end up being a functional cure at first, because it will keep on killing all the active copies that it comes across. And then once the active copies are all taken care of, I think a fresh load will come from hidden reservoirs. And those hidden reservoirs can be identified and killed by EBT as soon as they become active. And this way, all the places that the AAV can reach will progressively find HIV reservoirs depleted. But at the end of the day, if there is still HIV in the brain, it's likely to create copies and send it across the body. So that's the last frontier that has to be crossed, in my opinion. So that's what I think, my friends. And I'm going to read a little bit more on this aspect, because it's a very interesting area. And if you guys have any questions, please put that in the comment section below, because I'll include that in my reading in order to get to the bottom of this. This is just a first first glance kind of a thing, my initial thoughts based on everything I have read so far. But I'll make a new video on this later on, in which I'll talk about this in greater detail after having investigated all the aspects. I know for sure that NIH has published a small paper on AAV9 variants which have the capability to cross the blood-brain barrier, but they have cautioned that they still need to understand all the implications and whatever will happen based on that. I also know that there are companies like Ginkgo Bioworks who have got into collaboration with Biogen in order to come up with better ways of manufacturing AAVs to scale and the proper concentration. So there is a lot of activities going on in those areas. But the other aspect we have to realize also is that many human bodies can be immune to AAVs, and then AAV as a carrier may not be as effective. So the AAVs will have to be cloaked. So that adds a further complexity as time goes by. So we'll see how this thing progresses. I'm still optimistic that functional cure for sure should come by 2027. Sterilizing cure is a thing that we can aspire for in the future. But EBT101, in my opinion, is the closest we can come to a sterilizing cure, provided we take care of the blood-brain barrier and also reaching the all the organs where HIV could be. Well, friends, that was my thoughts on EBT101. And thanks for the question to our subscriber who asked that question. And I think it was worth bringing to the rest of you. So stay optimistic and stay hopeful, because this does not prevent a functional cure from coming in. So a functional cure definitely is way superior than having maybe an injection once in every 2 months or once in every 6 months. So with that, my friends, I'd like to bring this video to an end. And I'll catch up with you again in the next video. Bye for now.